CityNow.org, the quarantine report. I'm Amy Goodman. The novel coronavirus continues to ravage the United States, where the official death toll is rapidly approaching 50,000, more than a quarter of the 191,000 deaths reported worldwide from COVID-19. A tally by Johns Hopkins researchers Thursday found more than 3,000 people died of the disease in the U.S. in just 24 hours, and many funeral directors and medical examiners say thousands more U.S. deaths from COVID-19 remain uncounted. The disease continues to batter the U.S. economy. On Thursday, the Labor Department reported another 4.4 million U.S. workers filed for unemployment benefits over the last week, raising new jobless claims over the past 5 weeks to more than 26 million, a scale that hasn't been seen since the Great Depression. On Capitol Hill, House lawmakers went back to Congress and voted overwhelmingly Thursday to approve another $483 billion in emergency relief. Most of the money will replenish the Paycheck Protection Program set up to provide forgivable loans to small businesses. New York Congressmember Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez blasted Republicans for refusing to take up new assistance to hard-hit U.S. residents like cash payments and food aid in the latest relief bill. And she pointed to big businesses like corporate chain restaurants that got tens of millions of dollars in loans meant for small businesses.
The only folks that they have urgency around are folks like Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and Shake Shack. Those are the people getting assistance in this bill. You are not trying to fix this bill for mom and pops. And we have to fight to fund hospitals, fighting to fund testing. That is what we're fighting for in this bill. It is unconscionable. If you had urgency, you would legislate like rent was due on May 1st and make sure that we include rent and mortgage relief for our constituents.
Most lawmakers, including House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, wore masks throughout Thursday's historic proceedings, except when delivering speeches from the House floor. Pointedly, a group of at least a dozen House Republicans refused to cover their faces over the objections of their colleagues and the medical advice of the House physician. At least 34 members of Congress have tested positive for COVID-19, which has touched the families and friends of people across Capitol Hill. This is California Democratic Congressmember Maxine Waters.
I'm going to take a moment to dedicate this legislation to my dear sister, who is dying in a hospital in St. Louis, Missouri right now, infected by the coronavirus.
Massachusetts Senator, former presidential candidate Elizabeth Warren, said Thursday her oldest brother died in an Oklahoma hospital this week, 3 weeks after he tested positive for the coronavirus. Donald Reed Herring was 86 years old. Senator Warren tweeted, "It's hard to know that there was no family to hold his hand or to say I love you one more time, and no funeral for those of us who loved him to hold each other close," she said. At the White House, the top scientist of the Department of Homeland Security Thursday outlined new research showing the novel coronavirus suffers from exposure to warm and humid conditions and from high levels of ultraviolet light. The findings, which have not yet been peer-reviewed, suggest that coronavirus may become less contagious during summer months. President Trump seized on the news at Thursday's White House Coronavirus Task Force briefing.
So, supposedly hit the body with a tremendous, whether it's ultraviolet or just very powerful light. And I think you said that it's been changed. And then I said, supposing you put the light inside the body, which you can do either through the skin or
Dr. Anthony Fauci, that the U.S. needs to significantly ramp up testing. Public health experts say a vast expansion of both diagnostic and serology tests are needed before any states can safely begin reopening their economies. Outside the White House, dozens of drivers blared car horns Thursday as they drove along Pennsylvania Avenue, displaying protest signs reading, "Trump lies, people die, and give us PPE." A small group of protesters deposited effigies of body bags on the sidewalk outside the Trump International Hotel as the protest convoy surrounded the building.
Every day people die unnecessarily because we don't have testing. We don't have adequate.